Hi guys, in this video I show you how to read a C string from the console into a variable. I first declare a new string for the prompt. This prompts the user to enter your name. Next I declare a couple more strings. The first one will be a name, and I declare this as an array of 20, and another which is a pointer called response. Then I prompt the user to enter the name, so I output the prompt. And next I want to read the input into the name variable. For this there's a fgets function. This expects three arguments. The first one is the string that I want to read into. The next one is the size, or the maximum size of the characters I want to read. So this should ideally match the number of or the size of the string, the number of characters that the string can hold. And finally, the file here, this is the input stream. So I can read from a file or I can read from the console. So in this case, I pass in name, 20, and std in, standard in, because I want to read from standard in, which is the console. Now, this function also returns a value. And the value is my response here. That's where I assign it to. So this response will get the value that this function returns. If the function reads the input successfully into the variable, essentially this variable will be returned. It's a reference to this, or a pointer to this variable. Now, if there's an error, it will return null. So after I read anything in using fgets, I need to check the returned value if it is null or not null. If it is null, if it's null, there was an error. If it's not null, it read successfully. So here I check if response is not null, then I output your name is, and here I output the name. Otherwise, else, I output error by reading name. Now I run this program, and here I can enter a name, let's say John, and then it outputs your name is John. So it read it successfully. Now another thing to watch out for when you're reading strings is that you actually have memory allocated. You notice if I would to change this to just a pointer, the pointer has never been initialized. I didn't allocate memory where I can actually store this name. It's really just a pointer that doesn't have anything available right now. So if I run this and I enter a name here, John, you can see exec bad access exception that was thrown here because it couldn't read anything. It didn't have any memory to where to store the input, the characters. So it's important that I have enough memory here reserved. Also, let's try out if I put 2, and let's see what we get. So you notice that I have a size of 2 characters, but I actually read up to 20 characters. So if I read this, this works, but there's a big problem because I only have 2 characters, so it will read the characters beyond the length of the array. So it will override other memory, and this could really cause big troubles in your program somewhere else, that you get corrupted data or somehow your program might crash. So you can get unexpected results. So always be sure that the number of characters you read is never larger than the size of the string. Now, I declared an additional variable response here to capture the return value. Many times you don't really need to declare an additional variable for that. What you can do instead, and I show this again, you use the fget function, and you directly use it in the condition, and then you check that it did not return null. So here, your name is, and I output this again, otherwise error occurred. Now you see that I simply read in the input into the name variable, and then I check the return type directly if it's null or not. That way I don't have to deal with declaring an extra variable, assigning the return value to the variable, and then checking the return value. So this is much cleaner. And I comment this code for now. I don't really need this. And when I run this, you will see it works just the same like the one before. I can type in John, and here it says, your name is John. So this is probably the preferred way, since you don't have to declare this extra variable when you're reading input into a variable. You do want to be sure that you check for not null, that you capture an error if one occurred. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching.